Devraj got caught red-handed while committing the sin of hurting the weak. He was caught by Salimin district's local hero Krishan Gupta. Krishan got hold of Devraj and turned him in to one of the royal guards. Just when he was about to leave, he...
Adi, I told you many times. Beta, you have to come to the dinner table at 9 o'clock. I don't know what you do here. Please get up, wash your hands and come for dinner. Adi, are you listening to me? What do you keep writing in this diary?
Nani, I don't show it to anybody, okay? It's our personal diary.
Adi, come on, you can share anything with me.
Nani!
What Nani? You start sharing with me, Beta. I'm your only parent. God knows how much time I have in this world today.
Can you please stop saying that? It's pure emotional blackmail, for God's sakes.
But Beta, I'm worried about your future. If you keep on writing, when will you study? You are in grade 12 and you don't even know what your future is like. You have to work hard. Why don't you give up writing?
I think I study enough at school anyway, okay?
You need to improve your grades if you want to go to a good college. This will not help you. This is wasting your time.
My grades are fine the way they are.
Don't listen to me. Do whatever you want to do.
I attend school every day for 7 hours, okay? And unlike my friends, I know actually what's going on in school because I listen to what my teachers say. And I have a life of my own too, you know, just
Adi,
me alone.
You need to understand that I will not always be here to provide for you. Stop being childish.
How am I being childish?
Forget it. No point arguing with you. Oh, by the way, Kabir is coming tomorrow. Please clean up your room and come down for dinner. It's getting cold.
Hi, Dadi. How are you doing?
Oh, Kabir. Come in, beta. Come in. I'm fine. How is life with you?
It's all right. By the way, how is Adi?
Go and ask him yourself. He's in his room.
Okay. Adi. Yeah. Yeah, I'll just note it down. Just 1 second. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Chapter 12. What? Is Adi a writer?
Hey, Kabir.
Hi.
Hey, that's my personal diary, man.
Sorry, my bad, dude. How are you doing?
What's up? It's going good. You know, it's my 12th grade, so I expect my school to start mock exams in a week. You tell me, what's been up with you?
Yeah, I've been going to the gym actually. But apart from that, nothing much. It's really hot out here. I'm feeling thirsty. Could you get me some water?
Dude, you've been here so many times. You know where to get the water from. Go get it yourself. I'm not going.
Actually, as I told you, I've been going to the gym and I sort of hurt my leg there. I don't want to move around too much.
Okay, I mean, if you say so. I'll go get it. I'll be right back, okay?
Yeah.
I got you a water, bro.
I'll be out in just a minute.
Okay. I'll put it outside.
Yeah, dude, I'm coming.
Just a minute.
Unbelievable. He never told me how good he was.
You are doing so well. I don't know what to do to make Adi take his future seriously. He shuts himself in his room, keeps writing. He doesn't come out, he doesn't speak.
Wait, what? His writing was so good. How does she not? Of course she doesn't know.
Wait. Take a look at this.
No? Why?
You know what she does for a living? Well, she's a co-founder of Gem Publication. And you know, I sent your book to her.
What?
She has liked your 11th chapter. She said she has not seen anyone teen writer writing with such maturity. She wants to see me tomorrow.